What up, gamers? T.U.G here. This is episode 5B, the ultimate Let's Play Strong Badia's cool game for attractive people. Something has just happened in Strong Badia. Oh my.
Trogdor? No! Bad Trogdor! Heal! My poor kingdom! You were never supposed to burninate my countryside! I thought we were BFFs! That's burninating friends forever.
Hey, Strong Bad, is this a bad time?
I wasn't crying. Wait, Homestar, where are you?
I'm in your interface. Pretty cool, huh?
Well, get out! I got enough to worry about without you getting all up in my hood like some kind of pop-up spam.
Yeah, that's a problem. I think I'm stuck in this video game unless you can find a way to get me out. By the way, did you know that total load can enlarge your vectoroid region by 27%? Click here to find out how.
Oh, first the burnination of Strong Badia? Now I've got home spam! Trogdor, you mess with the wrong player character this time. I can't believe I'm about to say this, but I have no other choice. I must kill Trogdor! Anybody know how to kill a dragon?
Hey, listen! Those guys in video games are always killing dragons. Have you tried getting into the video game and asking one of them?
How am I supposed to get in the game?
You want to get in the game? You gotta want it! Be the ball! Live your dreams! Believe in yourself! You never get a second chance to make a first impression! Now are you gonna get in there and show that dragon who's in, boss?
Yeah!
I can't hear you! But I'm gonna assume you said yeah. The acoustics in this video game are terrible.
Okay, so to get in the game, we literally have to get in the game. I'll worry about that in a bit. There's a couple of things I want to check to see what else has happened here. Trogdor's still stalking us in the background. Whoa! A limousine party bus?
No way! I told you we should have taken the Space Jersey Turnpike!
Man, weird things are happening everywhere. The Algebros? What are they doing here?
Well, if it isn't the Algebros, the entertaining fireball-chucking stars of Math Kickers. What's the total, Brodels? Yeah, I pretty much gotta kill a dragon to get all you guys back where you belong. Wanna come with?
Apparently that's all it can say. So now the Algebros have joined us.
Man, it's worth it just
one
to
of many
those
that
guys
we'll encounter.
Boxes up.
All right, let's see what else is going on here. What in the blue hell happened to Marzipan? My god. She's gone completely ape. She's become Marzikong.
What was that all about?
All kinds of weird goings on, Strong Bad. There was that big flickering and flashing in the sky, and then Marzipan went plumb loco balanco. See what I mean?
Oh, is Marzipan having one of our episodes again? You just gotta pretend you're listening to her. Let me handle this. Yes, Marzipan, you're right, of course. Good point. Missed me! You call that a throw? Give her the old 1-2.
Hey, that was my favorite bush! I wonder what's behind there.
That's actually opened up a new area.
I think I actually like Marzi Kong better this way.
Well, I don't. Help me get rid of her.
Well, at least she's not talking, bubs. Man. Let's see what the cool car has.
Change car-esque. Full autopilot. Razor-tipped saw blade hubcaps. And... snakes? I don't remember adding snakes.
Why didn't I remember to add snakes?
Well, that's ground. We may need them later. But don't put them in your pants.
Note to self. Best place for keeping a tangle of writhing snakes? Not my pants.
And if you live where I do, you gotta watch out for rattlesnakes. Back when I lived in Scottsdale a few years ago, we actually had a rattlesnake in my front yard. Crazy. Okay, so why don't we check out this area here?
Margie Kong was tossing these things around like she's got an infinite supply of them.
Let's check out this new area. Apparently the poopsmith is here for some odd reason. Look at all these crates, though. There's got to be something here. What the?
Whoa, I almost stepped in Snake Boxer. Oh, I get it. I almost didn't see you there. What with you being two-dimensional and all.
Yeah, maybe he'd go well with the snakes we got.
You know, your lucky fists of fury could come in pretty handy. Wanna join my party to save reality?
All right, so we can use the combination of snakes and the snake boxer to break open some crates.
I realize I'm asking a lot from a bunch of pixelated snakes with, at most, a dozen or so lines of code between them. But could you just sit here on this crate and, slither for a while? Cool. Thanks.
Now we put Boxer Joe on. That's apparently his name.
The slimy green corner, weighing in at, 800 pounds, is a crate covered in snakes. And in the blue corner, weighing in at 128 pixels, is the Flatland Flattener, the Asp Assassin, the Python Pounder, the one and only Snake Boxer! That was
what
quick.
We got in here?
Those snakes must have taken a dive.
Well, they opened up the crate for us. The light musket.
All right, the light musket peripheral from Spirits of 76, complete with photonic ramrod and frequency frizzin. With this baby, I'll be able to blast wavelengths of liberty at all sorts of stuff.
Okay, we got our rank up there. So we can actually equip the musket and shoot off blasts of light. That should come in handy a little bit later for a later mission. That's basically what it can do. We'll worry about the poopsmith later, because I think there's one more crate we can get. The one just outside the area. Not the ones that Marzi Kong is throwing. This one right here.
How about it, guys? There's probably an ancient relic in there or something. And I know you snakes love that kind of stuff.
Okay, Snake Boxer, do your thing.
Round one, fight!
What do we got in here?
My very own EGA question hat! I'll be able to do all kinds of stuff in this. Look stone, get brooch, talk barkeep. The possibilities are endless.
Obviously, he's referring to the game Peasant's Quest, a game within a game of the Strong Bad universe. Now, I believe if we go back and reopen the crate we did earlier, we'd actually get something else.
Snakes on a crate. It's the box for the Videlectrix Half-Athalon, voted best sports-related game by Videlectrix Power Magazine for 3 years running.
Okay, so that was one of the collectibles. I believe the collectibles in this game are the cards, the Graphketeers cards, the game boxes, and the Cheat Commandos action figures. We haven't gotten any of those yet. But let's head back to the Trogdor machine. Time to get in the game. And I'm talking that quite literally here. First, I'm going to show off what we need to collect. There's actually three games we need to clear, aside from one in the previous four episodes. There's actually three in this one to get the full 100%.
Get in the game. All right. Let's do this.
Wish I could pixelate like that and get in an arcade cabinet like that.
I'm up. Nobody saw that. It's cool. Whoa, what is this place? It's like every cool video game ever made, all in one place. Am I in heaven?
Hey, Strongbad.
No, clearly not heaven.
Word on the street is you're trying to take down this Trogdor character.
That's right, Homestar. You were there when I said it out loud twice.
Shh, never know who might be listening. I hear there's a regular Trogdor killing expert inside peasantry. Fellow by the name of Rather Dashing. Tell me H-Star Man sent you.
Okay, well, there's a bunch of different ways we go about this. First thing I'm going to do, though, is go here to Space Circus Catastrophe.
Space Circus Catastrophe? No way am I going in there. Those evil space clowns are bad news, man. I love those performing bears, though.
Reason me to get one of these guys.
No! Down, boy! Down! Oh, he's already gotten attached! Now I gotta keep him.
Yeah, part of the 100% is to get all of the,
That's a cool game for attractive people.
Party members. I believe there's 10 of them total.
Like guns and swords and setting things on fire! And not one of those boring, use pie on cat type jobs.
Kind of ironic. I'm not sure what exactly happens when we go through this way. Oh, we just gotta get sent back into the real world. Okay. Alright, I gotta get back in there. Okay. We're gonna go here to Gel Arshi's
Fruit Border. That's the game the cheat was wanting to play in my bedroom. I wonder if it's any less lame when you see it on the inside.
Now, that's actually one of the games we get to play for the 100%. We're going to be doing a storyline-related event here, though, first. Unfortunately, we got to deal with that annoying creep.
I don't remember the Gel Arshi game looking like this.
What are you doing back here? Nobody's allowed backstage without a chaperone.
Look, having to talk to you is no bowl of cherries for me either.
Cherries? Where? I love cherries.
Anyways, as I was saying, I thought I was jumping into the game. How come you're just standing around here, not loafing?
That's because nobody's playing the game. I'm in attract mode.
Nothing attractive about that. Okay. Now, the whole concept of the game is they're shooting fruit and those pineapple slices at you. Object is to get all the cherries and all the red vegetables or fruits, wherever they are, and avoid the pineapples. Now they're shooting up a lot more of the ammo. Let's go to the fruit supply here.
I could not push for no reason.
Another law of video games: if there's a lever to be pressed, press it. I think that's all we need to do here. Let's talk to Gel Arshi real quick.
So, freak show.
Hey kids, come to watch me get radical on the half pipe.
Oh, I'm looking for anybody to help me get farther in the video game so I can kill a dragon.
Well, keep looking. Around here, I'm in charge. I'm the god. And I ain't leaving till somebody hits the kill scream.
Hey, Strongbad, what's a kill scream?
Oh, that's when you play a video game for so long and get a score so high and have a life so depressing that you break the video game.
Hey, Strongman, why is the sky blue?
Go away, Homestar. You only get one question per day.
It's like getting to level 256 on Pac-Man. Once you get past that, the game just kind of malfunctions itself. It is legitimately called a kill screen. And speaking of Pac-Man, that is somehow still my number one most watched video of all time. Still don't know how that happened. I only got to level 6. Whatever.
I better find a place for the Gel Arshi game on here, so I know to avoid it.
Alright. Can't talk to Trogdor. He's just burning everything. Alright, why don't we just head home? Let's see what we can do about that Gel Arshi thing.
Great. And now the house is haunted.
Ghosts? You go on ahead without me, big guy. I'll stay back in the van with the Jeep.
One, you don't have a van. Two, I wish I could get rid of you that easily. And three, these aren't even the groundskeeper wearing a sheet covered in phosphorescent paint kind of ghosts anyway. They're from Spirits of 76. That bicentennial themed game where you're a big spooky pixel running around a black screen, picking up other spooky pixels.
Are they? Gulp. Spooky ghost pixels.
So now the house is haunted, we gotta clear them out. First things first, let's grab this box we passed up earlier.
I was wondering where the box for my Lady Crate Ape game had gone to. I mean, Strong Sad's Lady Crate Ape game that sucks, and he sucks too because of it.
Alright, well, I'm just about out of time here. I'm going to call it quits here. Next episode, we'll play a little ghost busting here at the House of Strong. So until then, I'm T.U.G. Later, gamers.